Welcome to Kempner Sports. My name is Rev Trev, and today we're diving into fantasy football, the show fantasy football that we are going to be talking about a crucial thing called wide receiver strategy. You need to be thinking about your wide receivers and not just round one or two. You need to be thinking about your round three, four, five, six, what those ones, those tier two, tier three wide receivers. Just a quick reminder that we said in one of those first videos is that fantasy football is all about educated guessing. It's hard to predict the future. It's hard. Everyone thinks, oh yeah, this guy's going to bust out. We don't know about health. We don't know about schemes that teams are making offensively, defensively. We don't even know which teams are going to be good defensively. But we do know the talent. You can see the talent there. And if they're healthy and they can put things together, get drives going, have a bit of a running game, it just opens up the pass game. And as you can see, there's so many great quarterbacks that you can take, and that's why we're waiting on quarterback this year, is so because we can get those wide receivers, and usually, not usually, always, a great wide receiver is going to be tied to a great quarterback. There are exceptions to the rule. Mitch Trubisky to Allen Robinson, that's a difference, that's an exception to the rule. Now, Trubisky's gone, we don't know how Dalton is going to go, they should be starting Fields. But you need to have your wide receivers tied to a stud quarterback, and then you're going to have a lot more better chance of having success. And so always when it comes to draft strategy, everything that trumps draft strategy is picking the right player. But how do you know which players to pick? Some of you are like, hey, Trevor, what would be your rankings. I don't do a lot of rankings on here because at the end of the day, it's your team and you got to make your decisions. I want to help you with strategy and I want to talk about players. I'm going to be talking about players today. Then I want to let you know who I think has value in these spots. Okay, for example, I think there's a tier above themselves. I would call it a super elite tier, and there's two players in that, Devontae Adams and Tyreek Hill. And if you wanted to go Tyreek Hill over Adams, I have no problem with that. As a Packers fan, I would prefer Adams over Hill, but I'm happy with either one of those guys. Then I believe in that first tier, there's a big drop-off. In fact, last year, both Adams and Hill had over 240 fantasy points. The next highest was Stephon Diggs at 200. And if you go all the way down that list is amazing because it goes Adams, Hill, Diggs, Ridley, Metcalf, Jefferson, Thielen, Evans, A.J. Brown, and Hopkins. That's your top 10 from last year. It goes from, once it drops to 200, it only drops at 172 to be number 10. And so there's a big gap at the elite guys at the top, the super elite guys at the top, and then the rest are very similar. And we're going to get into tiers 2 and 3 in just a second, but which ones are the studs right now? I want to show you a list right now. This is from 2019. So just two seasons ago, this is the list of the top 10 players. Michael Thomas. What do we do with Michael Thomas this year? No Drew Brees. You've got Taysom Hill or Jameis Winston. Like, who's going to start there? Who's going to play there? Thomas is hurt. You're getting Thomas in the 7th, 8th round. He was number 1 2 years ago. Godwin had a breakout year. Galladay's a super great, I would say, tier 2 wide receiver, but he's always hurt. And now he's on the Giants, and so that's going to be awesome for Daniel Jones. You got Cooper Kupp, who now is a new quarterback. Then you had Julio Jones, Devontae Parker, like he fell off the map in 2020. Amari Cooper, Mike Evans, A.J. Brown, and Hopkins. On those two lists of 2020 to 2020, from 2020 to 2019, the only three guys that are on those, both of those lists is Mike Evans, AJ Brown and Hopkins, and they are solid. You know that you can take, you're going to get production from those guys. They are, that's why they can be considered tier one players. So what is a tier one player? These are my tier one players. Adams, Diggs, Hill, Hopkins, Ridley, Metcalf. I feel like I'm missing some guys here. Jefferson, and then AJ Brown, I would have to up there. Obviously, did I say Hopkins? I think I already said him there. There's a number of guys. I feel like I'm missing a guy there. But tier two, this is what I would consider tier two. So, and not necessarily in this order, but McLaurin, Keenan Allen, CeeDee Lamb, Mike Evans, Allen Robinson. Those are would be my second tier. And then my third tier would be Julio, Tyler Lockett, Robert Woods, Thielen, Godwin, Cooper Kupp, and Amari Cooper. And so, you know, wide receivers are boom and bust. One week you can get a wide receiver, he gets four catches for 43 yards. And then another week, that same guy gets eight catches for 225 yards and three touchdowns. It's like he wins your week, right? And this is why people like the running backs, because they seem they're more consistent. But last year, there were so many injuries and so many issues with running backs that is actually it was better to have a wide receiver strategy. And I switched my strategy at the end of the season, walking into the playoffs, and I had traded for Tyler Lockett. He was my flex player. I had Hopkins and Thielen, and then in my flex at the time was Lockett, and he was that boomer. He had a week that he had 35 fantasy points, went nuts. His great speed, great route running, but Seahawks really struggled in the second half. That was a bad move by me. I ended up losing my playoffs because of that move. But if I would have had the right wide receiver, for example, if I would have gotten Jefferson, I would have won my league instead of lose my league. And so that is where all this happens, right? So again, those lists are just who I think they're in tiers. You have to decide, like, what are you gonna do in my tier three? Where do you pick Julio Jones? Like, he's a super stud athlete. He just doesn't score enough touchdowns. Is he gonna score more touchdowns in Tennessee? With AJ Brown there, with Henry there? You know, it's tough to say. And these are the question marks that you need to wrestle with. You got to figure out who you want. Do a list of players and say, I would take this guy over this guy, this guy over this guy. Now, I just want to quickly jump in to two things. The same guy, Haystack, that I want to talk about. And then also, so this is would be tier 4, 5, 6. They're all kind of jumbled together, okay? And then I also want to go into certain wide receiver combos, tandems, and then I want to talk to you about a mock draft. So I'm going to do this as fast as I can. Hopefully it's not too fast for you. So there's this point in the draft you get, and it's the same guy strategy. It's like, it doesn't matter who you're going to pick. It's trying to pick a needle in a haystack. And some of the players on this list, and I'm just going to post it right here or here. I don't know which side I'm going on today, but these are when you get into the draft, these are your options. Okay. So T. Higgins, Chase Claypool, again, a boom or bust. Like he would score massive fantasy weeks and would be on most people's bench. I think he's going to be starting for a lot of teams this year. Fuller, Judy, Robbie Anderson, DJ Shark, Juju Smith-Schuster, Michael Gallup, Cooks, Chenault, again, Michael Thomas is there, Marquise Hollywood Brown, which a lot of people are predicting he's going to have a bust out year, hasn't done it yet in his career, Debo Samuel, he is an amazing, amazing wide receiver. He hasn't been healthy yet. Devontae Smith, the rookie. Chase, the rookie. Weddle, the rookie. Tyler Boyd, Curtis Samuel, now with Fitzmagic. Mike Williams, healthy with a Herbert. Henry Ruggs, who was touted as an incredible wide receiver. Does he take a step this year? Antonio Brown's getting a lot of love. We already talked about Waddle. Jarvis Landry, Marvin Jones, Corey Davis with Zach Wilson. Like, needle in a haystack. And this is just reality. So you got to decide which of these guys have the best chance to breaking out and being a great player, to be that at least flex or number two overall, or two number two slot wide receiver on your fantasy team. That's what you're looking for in this needle in the haystack. Now, let's quickly run into the combos. There's three teams I want to do, and I'm only going to do the NFC today. It's Tampa Bay, Dallas, and the Rams. So, Tampa Bay, Tom Brady, incredible quarterback, the greatest of all time, most likely. Here he is, 44 years old. There was a day where Peyton Manning was like super elite, and all of a sudden there's something wrong with my neck, and now I'm declining and I'm retiring, right? Tom Brady, how long is he going to play? I don't know. I just know I can't bet against Tom Brady at this stage of his career, but this could be the year. And maybe this going after Tampa Bay guys is terrible. Maybe they just fall off the map. But most people don't believe that, and that's why these guys are ranked high. So Godwin, Evans, AB, which one of those guys do you want? Is Godwin going to have a better year than Evans? Is Evans going is Antonio Brown going to have 1,000 yards, 1,200 yards? People love Antonio Brown as a sleeper. The problem is Antonio Brown's already getting in fights in practice or in the preseason, and he's Antonio Brown. Super elite. He would have been in that super elite tier of quarterback or wide receivers back in the day. But now he's this guy who's a loose cannon and you don't know how to trust. And a lot of people are saying he's the sleeper you want. Dallas, for example, the biggest story about Dallas isn't their wide receiver core, because they're all super talented. In fact, they're probably top 2-3 in the whole league. But the big news is Dak Prescott healthy? And can Dak Prescott do what he did last year, throwing 400 to 500 yards a game? If he can, he's going to have three wide receivers with over 1,000 receiving yards and a whole bunch of touchdowns. We just don't know. And this is where it goes. So I love CeeDee Lamb. I actually am a huge CeeDee Lamb fan for this season. But he is, I don't know if I don't love him where I have to pick him. I think he's too high. That's just my personal opinion. Some of you are like, oh, good, because I'm in your league and I'm going to take him. Go for it. And you probably will be right, or you might be right. I'm always right, babes, or sometimes right. I would rather have Amari Cooper a couple rounds later. I don't know. I would be okay with a very last pick, or right before you pick a defense and a kicker, to pick Gallup. He's solid, but I wouldn't be depending on him as my number two wide receiver on a fantasy team. Then we move over to the Rams. And the Rams went from Goff to Stafford. That's apparently an upgrade. I think it's an upgrade. And people aren't talking about Robert Woods. Why aren't they talking about Robert Woods and Cooper Kupp? I mean, they're considered tier three wide receivers. And with Stafford, if they have good chemistry and connection, they could be tier two wide receivers, no problem. And that's where you might be able to get a steal there. So these are the things, and I don't really know how to rank the rookie wide receivers. In fact, most years, rookie wide receivers take a year or two or three to really produce. Then you get some of those Metcalfs and McLaurins and different guys like that who didn't, and Jefferson, who didn't need a couple years. They were great in year one. And so that is the challenge. So let me just finish this video today with this. I went into a mock draft today trying to do wide receiver strategy. So what I wanted to do is I got pick six, and I thought, okay, I'm going to try to go and get a wide receiver in the first round and then go from there. So in the first round, first six picks come up, and there were so many superstar elite running backs, I couldn't do it. I could have picked anyone I wanted for wide receiver, and I went with Nick Chubb, because I'm a big Nick Chubb fan. And then I was hoping to get one of those super elite wide receivers. The problem is Adams, Hill, Ridley, Diggs, all those guys started going. And the guy that I got was Metcalf. And I'm happy with Metcalf. I think he's good. He didn't have the greatest year last year, but he had a really solid year. So I got one of those guys, okay? So that was the second round. Going into the third round, I had a decision to make. Do I pick a running back or do I go wide receiver? And because I want to do the wide receiver, I went there. But here were the running backs available. David Montgomery, Chris Carson, Dobbins, and Henderson. And I just, at that stage, I don't love any one of those guys any more than the wide receivers. The wide receivers available was CeeDee Lamb, McLaren, Allen Robinson, and Keenan Allen. And I just, because I've never drafted CeeDee Lamb, I'm like, I'm going CeeDee Lamb there. And I picked him. I felt good about that pick. Going into the fourth round, I got Mike Evans, top 10 guy. I like Mike Evans. I was really happy with that pick. If I knew I could have got Mike Evans in the fourth, I probably wouldn't have taken Lamb in the third, but maybe not. And then the running backs were going off the board. Like, I was in big trouble running back-wise, and I fluked out, and I barely got Josh Jacobs. Now, a lot of controversy over their O-line and just their situation bringing in Drake, so maybe that's not a great pick at five. At six, I had wanted, actually, at Evans or at Jacobs, I wanted a tight end there, one of the elite tight ends. I knew Kelsey was already gone, and I'm missing a guy. Who's the number two guy? And then there's Kittle. I was hoping to get one of those guys, but Pitts and Andrews were there, so I decided to go with Andrews in six. Seven and eight, I just took some running backs. I was hoping to get a quarterback there, but literally Herbert, Wilson, Rodgers, Lamar Jackson, Dak Prescott, all were going there, and I couldn't get them. So I wanted to wait on quarterback. I waited too long. I missed out on some of those guys. And in the ninth round, I picked up Tom Brady. So still good. Still good. Not elite. Used to be elite. But he's amazing still. He's good. He's just not amazing. In the 10th round, I picked Juju Schuster. And with a healthy Big Ben, he could have a good year. And then in the 11th round, I took Drake just to handcuff Jacobs. And then I picked in the 12th round, Jarvis Landry. And so I like that team. If I'm going, these wide receivers, Metcalf, Lamb, and Evans every single week, and having Lamb or Evans in my flex, I can compete with anybody. Having Tom Brady there, having the tight end was okay there. I think I can compete with anyone. So I don't know, what do you think? What do you think? What are some of your breakout wide receivers this year? I'd love for you to put in the chat. Also, Subscribers League, we only have one spot left, and as you know, it's going to be a super flex league. If you want to be a part of it, hit that subscribe button. Be a subscriber today. Put in the comment section, I'm interested, and I'll send you an invite. You'll be eligible for an invite, and I'd love to compete against you. Peter Day from our past videos and Stuart Dixon, they're in there too. I'm really excited about this year's subscriber league, and it's going to be incredible. We're going to battle together, and we're going to be talking about this throughout the year. So your team's going to be talked about, my team's going to be talked about, and looking forward to that. Thanks again so much for watching. Please hit that like and subscribe to this channel. I really appreciate the support, and have a great day, everyone, and go win your fantasy league.